In the last video, I defined the surface integral of a scalar field. If the scalar field is just one, then the surface integral gives us the area of the surface. So I want to use the machinery of surface integrals to derive the surface area of a sphere. We all know it's 4 pi r squared, where r is the radius of the sphere. So we're going to parameterize the sphere using spherical coordinates. So x is r sine theta cosine phi, y is r sine theta sine phi, and z is r cosine theta. Capital R is fixed, so the sphere is a fixed radius, capital R. So this is a parameterization of the sphere in terms of the angles theta and phi. So our R then, which is a function then of the parameters theta and phi, is equal to x r sine theta cosine phi in the I direction plus y r sine theta sine phi in the j direction plus r cosine theta in the k direction, the z direction. Okay, to find the area of the surface area of the sphere, then we need to compute ds. To get ds, we need the partial derivatives of r. So we have the partial of r with respect to theta to begin with. The derivative of sine theta is cosine theta, so r cosine theta cosine phi I. The derivative of sine theta is cosine theta, so plus r cosine theta sine phi j minus r sine theta k. Okay? The other partial derivative is partial of r with respect to phi. That will be minus r sine theta sine phi I. The derivative of sine phi is cosine phi plus r sine theta cosine phi j. And the k component doesn't depend on phi, so we get 0. Okay, now we need to take the cross product of these two partial derivatives. So the cross product of partial of r with respect to theta times partial of r with respect to phi. That's equal to a 3 by 3 determinant. So we have the I component. Then we have the j component. And then we have the k component. Okay? So partial r with respect to theta, the r component is r cosine theta cosine phi. So we have an r cosine theta cosine phi. The j component is r cosine theta sine phi. So we have an r cosine theta sine phi. And the k component is minus r sine theta. So minus r sine theta. Okay? Partial of r with respect to phi. The I component is negative r sine theta sine phi. The j component is r sine theta cosine phi, r sine theta cosine phi. And the k component then is 0. Okay. So we need to compute this. So let me put it up here. So we have our dr d theta cross dr d phi. So the I component will be the determinant, this 2x2 determinant here, deleting the first column and the first row. So 0 minus minus. So we have an r squared sine squared theta cosine phi, r squared sine squared theta cosine phi. That's the I component. The j component is across the second column, first row, and then with a minus sign. So we go the other direction. So capital R squared sine squared theta sine phi plus R squared theta sine phi j. And then the k component is going to be this 2x2 determinant. So R cosine theta R squared cosine theta cosine squared phi plus R squared cosine theta sine squared phi. If you let me do some algebra in my head, we have a cosine squared phi plus a sine squared phi. So then we'll end up with an R squared cosine theta plus R squared cosine theta sine theta, because the sine squared phi is 1. And that's the k direction. Okay, what we need then is the magnitude of this. So we have the length of this vector, dr d theta cross dr d phi. What are the common terms here? There's an r squared, which is common. And then each term, these have a sine squared theta, sine squared theta, sine theta. So there's also a common sine theta. So we can factor them out. So we have an r squared sine theta. And then whatever is left over. So we need to square the components, add them, and then take the square root. So we have a sine theta cosine phi left over. So when we square them, we end up with sine squared theta cosine squared phi. Then we have sine theta sine phi left over. So when we square it, we have a sine squared theta sine squared phi. Finally, we have a cosine theta left over, only a cosine theta. So that becomes a cosine squared theta. And then this factor is supposed to be to the 1/2 power. So we squared the components, added them, and took the square root. Okay, this actually simplifies. So we have sine squared theta, times a cosine squared phi plus sine squared phi. That's 1. So this will give us sine squared theta. And then sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta is 1. So remarkably, this whole term in the parentheses is 1. The square root of 1 is 1. So this gives us r squared sine theta. Okay? So what we've done then is derive ds. Let me put that in red. So our ds here, then, is the length of this vector, r squared sine theta, times d theta d phi. And that's an important result that we'll use later in the when we talk about the fundamental theorems of vector calculus. Okay, now we have the remaining work to do. So the surface area of the sphere is the integral of our ds over the surface of the sphere. So this is going to be a double integral. So we have a double integral of r squared sine theta d theta d phi. Theta goes from 0 to pi. Phi goes from 0 to 2 pi. we need to do this integral, which is not very difficult. So this separates. So this is an integral. This is an r squared comes out. And then an integral from 0 to 2 pi of d phi times an integral from 0 to pi of sine theta d theta. The integral d phi from 0 to 2 pi is 2 pi. The integral of sine theta d theta from 0 to pi, if you do that, you get cosine. This will give you 2. So 2 times 2 pi is 4 pi times r squared. And we get the result that we know the answer to, the surface area of a sphere of radius capital R is 4 pi r squared. Wow, a lot of work to get an answer that we know already. But I show you then the machinery, and we also get the very nice result that the surface element of a sphere is r squared sine theta d phi. We'll make use of this one later. So let me summarize. We're computing the surface area of a sphere by doing a surface integral. It's a surface integral of a scalar field, but the scalar field is just 1. So that then we end up getting the surface area of the, we summing up all the DSs to get the surface area. We parameterize the sphere using spherical coordinates. We compute DS as r squared sine theta, d phi. We integrate DS, and we get 4 pi r squared. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.